There was nothing anyone could do when fire struck the home in Scottsmore near Mims, Brevard County.
And now friends and loved ones are mourning the 2-year-old who died in the flames. West 2's Gail Pascoe Brown is live at the fire station with the late-breaking details. Gail?
We can tell you the cause of this fire is still under investigation by the state fire marshal's office, but what a sad story this is. A young life is cut short. A family's home is destroyed. Now, we did speak with one neighbor who tried more than once to try to save this little boy.
I tried, but I couldn't find him.
The flames were too intense. The smoke was too thick at the Scottsmore mobile home fire. Carol Olsen says she tried to get her neighbor's 2-year-old son out of his burning home.
I seen April standing out here holding this one, and she started yelling at me, "The baby's in the house, Carol, the baby's in the house." And I said, "Where is he, April?" And she said, "He's in my room." So I put a tire against the trailer and I climbed in the window, but it was so full of smoke I couldn't see anything. And I was feeling around trying to find him. I could hear him crying.
But we couldn't see him.
She's caring for the victim's 4-year-old brother, Colton, who was also at home at the time of the fire. She says 3 other brothers, ages 13, 11, and 6, were all in school when the fire broke out. She tried again to rescue 2-year-old Cameron.
And I could still hear him, but it was getting to be a weaker cry. And I climbed back in, and I was calling to him, and I was feeling around, and I couldn't find him. By this time, the flames were coming through the door.
The fire broke out around 10:30 this morning in the 4700 block of Pine Needle in Scottsmore. By the time firefighters arrived, half of the structure was engulfed.
The original report we got, 911, told us that the child was still in the house and where the child was in one of the back bedrooms. So we knew that coming in.
When the boy's father got word, he was visibly shaken. The victim's mother was taken to ORMC with burns on her body. Now, the mother had serious burns over a large portion of her body, so she's being cared for. And as you can imagine, not only with the help, the family's going to need some mental health care and coping with this. The Red Cross is dealing with that, as well as accommodations, too. And, of course, when we find out about the cause of the fire, we'll bring that on to you. I'm Gail Pascoe Brown, live in Brevard County for West 2 News.